Guys, in this video, we want to look at this topic, unilateral nasal obstruction. So, nasal obstruction, if it is unilateral, only on one side, then what could be the causes? They can also ask it as unilateral nasal mass, give the differential diagnosis. So, all the reasons that can cause a unilateral obstruction in the nose. So, let's take a look at these. There are three parts to this. In the vestibule, what and all can be obstructing. In the nasal cavity, what and all can be obstructing. And in the nasopharynx, lastly, that is much behind, what can be obstructing. So, three parts. So, first of all, let us look at what can be obstructing in the vestibule. You know what vestibule is, right? See, this part of it, which has this epithelium of the skin similar, that is nasal vestibule. Then this part will be the nasal cavity. And then you have the nasopharynx. So, three parts they have divided. So, let us look at what and all can obstruct in the vestibule. Furuncle, something related to the skin, the hair follicles, isn't it? So, hair where do we see in the vestibule? So, definitely furuncle. Vestibulitis, name itself is vestibule. Vestibulitis, inflammation of the vestibule. Did we see the reasons for all this? Again, there can be because of rhinitis, sinusitis, nasal allergy, right? Trauma because of handkerchief, all that. Furuncle, hair follicle infection, staphylococcus, okay? Stenosis of nares. What are nares, by the way? Nares. Nares are the openings of the nostril, isn't it? So, those could have got stenosed. Then atresia. What is atresia? Absence or abnormal narrowing, degeneration. So basically absence or abnormal narrowing. So obviously there can be obstruction because of that narrowing. You know, actually in Young's operation, they block the nasal cavity, which is really very amusing. Wait, let's show. Young's operation, they will raise the skin flaps and close the nares. Here they are talking about unilateral. So probably they did this Young's operation only in the one side, isn't it? Then nasoalveolar cyst. What is alveoli in the nose? So basically this is a smooth bulge in the lateral wall and floor of the nasal vestibule. This image is showing nasoalveolar cyst. Okay. So, that could be a cause for unilateral obstruction. Let's just look at a photo of stenosis also. So, they have shown stenosis left nares due to smallpox. So, again, this is causing unilateral nasal obstruction. Then, papilloma, then they have put squamous cell carcinoma. Usually, all these tumors we want to mention in the end, right? Squamous cell carcinoma, papilloma. So, now can you summarize the causes of unilateral nasal obstruction, which can be the vestibule? Okay, so in the vestibule, the causes can be stenosis, vestibule furuncle, then atresia, furuncle, then what else we saw? Nasoalveolar cyst, then we saw some tumors, papilloma and squamous cell carcinoma. Something I'm missing after furuncle. What is that? Vestibulitis. Yes, very good. Let's move on then to the nasal cavity. Okay, we are moving to which part here? To this one. To nasal cavity we are going to move. Okay. So, we finished the vestibule. Now, let's check about what can cause obstruction in the nasal cavity. And that too, we want only unilateral causes. Okay. Unilateral causes. Foreign body. Foreign body went and got lodged there. Deviated nasal septum. So, the nasal septum. So, if this is the nose and this is the septum is deviated. So, definitely unilateral obstruction. Hypertrophic turbinates. The turbinates have overgrown. Right. So, let's draw the turbinates. The turbinates have overgrown. So, on one side that is hypertrophic turbinates. Concha bullosa. So, concha bullosa, what are they saying? Enlarged, ballooned out middle turbinate called concha bullosa. So, usually if it is middle turbinate, then only they are saying concha bullosa, isn't it? So, these turbinates are enlarged. Then, anthrocoanal polyp. So, here that is being represented. Anthrocoanal polyp. So, in nasal polyps, you have two types, right? Anthrocoanal polyp and ethmoidal polyps. So, basically, these will have a stalk. From where do they come out? From the mucosa of the maxillary antrum. Remember, in this, the presenting complaint, presenting symptom is unilateral nasal obstruction. Okay, but later it can become bilateral if it grows more. These anthrocoanal polyps, guys, they are common in children. Because of infection, it comes. They are usually solitary and they are unilateral, remember. From where are they coming? From maxillary sinus. They can grow backwards, right? And here, actually, they have shown it coming out of the nostril. This will be trilobed with three parts. What is this? Antral, nasal, and coanal parts. Antral, nasal, and coanal parts. Antronasal, coanal polyp, you can say, right? Because three things. Antral, nasal, coanal parts. Let's move on, guys. What are we looking at? We are looking at unilateral causes of nasal obstruction, nasal mass, differential diagnosis. Now, we have finished what? Anthrocoanal. Now, next one is what? Synechia. What is this? Adhesion formation between nasal septum and the turbinates. So, that is synechia. So, this is nothing but adhesion. So, what is getting stuck to what? Let's look at that again. Nasal septum and turbinates, isn't it? Septum and turbinate adhesion. Okay, then rhinolith stones, nose stones, then bleeding polyposis of septum, some polyps, polyposis, bleeding polyposis of septum. Lastly, always you will write tumors, benign and malignant tumors of nose, sinuses, then sinusitis, which is unilateral sinusitis. Okay, so let's take a recap of what we have seen so far. In the nasal cavity, why will there be obstruction? That too unilaterally. Why? Okay, so let us think and answer one by one. Anthrocoanal polyp. Then we saw some synechia. That's adhesion thing. Then lastly, we saw some tumors of the nose. Then sinuses. Then sinusitis, unilateral. Then initially, what did we see? Nasal cavity, foreign body. The person might have put a foreign body inside. Then what else? Let's go back and see. Deviated nasal septum, yes. Deviated nasal septum, concha bullosa. That's what we saw in this image. Something to do with the turbinate, concha bullosa. Right? Rhinolith. Sometimes we forget these easy things. Foreign body, rhinolith. These kind of go together. Foreign body, rhinolith. Deviated nasal septum, don't forget. Very common in ENT, right? Then, hypertrophic turbinates. Something related to turbinates, concha bullosa. Then bleeding polyposis of septum. Think about polyp. Bleeding polyposa of septum. Then tumors, benign and malignant, right? Both benign and malignant. And sinusitis, unilateral sinusitis. Okay. So now what and all are we done with? We are done with vestibule. We are done with nasal cavity. Lastly, what we have to go to? Nasopharynx. Yes. So let's go to nasopharynx now. So where is nasopharynx? First, we need to understand that. So, if we finished vestibule, we finished nasal cavity, now we are going to nasopharynx. So, in nasopharynx, what can be there? As a unilateral obstruction, because they are talking about unilateral, not about bilateral. Usually, this will be bilateral. What do you think? Because this is a common between both the things, right? So, it usually should be bilateral. But if there is a unilateral coanal atresia, then there can be a unilateral nasal obstruction. What is this coanal atresia? So basically you have seen this is more like a child they have shown. So here it is open. You see here it is open. Nose, nasopharynx open, but here there is an obstructive bone, bone or anything that is obstructing the nose to nasopharynx. So if it is unilateral, if this condition which is obstructing is unilateral, then it becomes unilateral nasal obstruction. Otherwise, definitely it is on both sides, then it can become bilateral. Okay, so we looked at all the three things that we wanted to look at in nasal obstruction. So what and all we looked at, let's take a recap. So unilateral nasal mass, so only one side, differential diagnosis we wanted. So we looked at the vestibule, we saw what? Pharyngeal vestibulitis, stenosis of nares, atresia, nasoalveolar cyst, papilloma, squamous cell carcinoma. Then when we came to nasal cavity, what did we see? Foreign body, rhinolith, deviated nasal septum, hypertrophic turbinates, concha bullosa, then anthracoanal polyp, bleeding polyposis, synychia. Between the septum and turbinate, there is adhesion. So, septum and turbinate, if they stick unilaterally, there will be unilateral nasal obstruction. Benign and malignant tumors of all this, sinusitis and sinusitis. Basically, you understood synychia, right? So, here is the nasal septum and here you have the turbinate. So, let's say the turbinate and the septum have synychia adhesion. So, definitely there is block. You can see, right? There is block now and unilateral. If it is adhesion, if this adhesion unilaterally, there is unilateral nasal obstruction. Lastly, we saw nasopharynx. Only one thing they have mentioned here, unilateral coanal atresia. Very important word, unilateral. Because it is unilateral, unilateral nasal obstruction. If it was bilateral, there would have been bilateral nasal obstruction. So that's all for now in this video. We'll meet you in the next video. Bye-bye.